Thanks for joining us on WXII12.com. I'm meteorologist Brian Slocum. Very interesting weather pattern is unfolding up and down the eastern seaboard as we speak. Locally, the effects will be much smaller than they will in other parts of the area, but they will be in our neighborhood, so to speak, with regard to the mid-Atlantic. A couple things we're watching. We do have a strengthening north wind today. It will keep conditions breezy about ahead of a cold front, and a very strong cold front at that. That's not bringing a lot of rain, but it will help increase the cloud deck as we go through time today. And also, of course, Sandy, a once hurricane, now tropical storm, tracking up the coastline, the outer bands of which are now starting to affect southern parts of the Carolinas and certainly coastal sections of the Carolinas. Our forecast does have rain in it, but I think the bulk of the rain is going to be from Raleigh toward the coastline. Having said that, any shift in the projected track of this storm at all, especially toward the coast, could bring some of the leading edge of those strong bands into the eastern parts of our area. I'm not going to say that's going to happen, but a couple of passing showers certainly will be a possibility. The heavier bands, again, should stay to our east today. So it's relatively a cloudy and breezy forecast with some occasional drizzle, mist, and maybe a passing shower from some of those bands that do break off and roll through the area. But at any given time today, our rain chances will be limited to about 20%. From Lexington to Stokesdale, high of 67 degrees, about 3 p.m. this afternoon. We'll start to bring those evening temperatures down. North winds at about 5 to 15 miles per hour. Looking farther west, McGrady up towards Sparta and Allegheny County, northward into Virginia. Temperatures will be also in the 50s the majority of the day, but should just creep into the lower 60s by day's end. Here's the latest model imagery and how this storm is going to behave. And it has weakened some in the last 48 hours or so. At its peak, moving in through the Caribbean, it did pack winds category 2 strength at 110 miles per hour. At last check, it had been weakened to in the 70s somewhere. You can see the bulk of the rain along the northern and western quadrants of our storm, which will affect the coastline and lash it with heavy rain and wind. Notice the eastward extent of the bands really don't make its way into the area until potentially moving into Monday. As the storm begins to strengthen a bit and curve toward the mid-Atlantic coastline, depending on where these bands set up, we could see our northern and eastern sections get hit with some of those heavy rain bands. In addition to that, that cold air I mentioned out west, going to pull in a lot of cold air around this storm, and we're expecting a snowy changeover, potentially some blizzard-like conditions with that strong wind in the area around that storm, moving through parts of Virginia, West Virginia, and even across the northern and western parts of our area. Could the triad see snow? It is a possibility that we could see some snowflakes mixing in with the rain, but I need to see more of a significant cool down Monday night and Tuesday before we go full blown into that type of forecast. As far as rainfall goes, the numbers are pretty staggering along the coastline. Could see 3 inches up to 10 inches. But by Monday into Tuesday, some lighter rainfall totals potentially across our northern and western areas. And we're looking at 1.3 inches in the triad, as this one of the models indicated. It's been doing a pretty good job with this rain, showing us some more impressive rainfall totals. Winds also expected to get to tropical storm strength along the outer banks. Potentially could see gusts in the 50 to 60 mile an hour range Sunday and Monday before things begin to settle down there as well. Looking at your 7-day forecast, temperatures 60s and 70s. In the days ahead, cooling down though significantly. If we see any flakes at all, it'll be during the night. Monday night and Tuesday, we'll see temperatures dropping near the freezing mark.